Maximizing the performance of the 145. And the comment that production planning makes the difference. Maybe we should say production planning can make the difference, or should make the difference. Or if we've got a very strong accountable manager, he would say shall make the difference. Production planning team may typically coordinate with both the commercial and technical service departments with a number of daily goals, ensuring that all the business processes and maintenance and repair challenges are addressed in the most economic and operationally flexible manner. And the difference with many of these departments and many of these functions within the business, it will happen. I guarantee you, an aeroplane goes in the hangar and it will come out of the hangar. It will be finished and it will go back into service. And how efficient that process is depends on a whole myriad of factors. And so even if we do it terribly in terms of our process and efficiency, it still happens. I saw, for example, with one company, an aeroplane went into the hangar in February and it was still there in August. They did everything wrong it was ever possible to do. Unbelievable. It started off with when they bought the aeroplane. When they bought the aeroplane, they didn't check the records properly. They just looked at the information, and when it was suggested, because they brought the aeroplane from Canada, as it happens, when it was suggested that they send a group of guys to do a full intensive, let's call it a pseudo airworthiness review, before acceptance of the aircraft, the big boss said, no, we can't spare people. And anyway, you're just after a jolly. You just want to go to somewhere to have a jolly. And sometimes this is the management perception. Yes. And so the aeroplane, yeah, you just want a trip. You just want a trip. It's like, I talk to guys, and when I'm talking to guys who are working, for example, in technical services, and looking at some of their roles and responsibilities, and I said, do you ever go to Boeing, for example? I said, do you ever go to Seattle for the conference? And the guy says, no, he's never been to Seattle. He said, I said, why not? He said, the boss won't let me go. He thinks it's a holiday. So, from Europe to Seattle, you get on an aeroplane and you fly for, you know, best part of 10 hours. And during that flight, you're very, very lucky if you're in business class, you know, most people are in economy. And so your time zone is shot to bits when you arrive there. And typically you're going to spend about 48 or 72 hours, 2 days is on a conference, and then you're going to come back on an aeroplane. And it's probably going to take you the best part of 2 weeks before your body feels okay again. This is not a jolly. But what happens when you go to such a conference, you change business cards, you meet people, and you understand that other people have the same problems as you, because you're meeting your peers in many different companies at a conference. It's very nice. You know, you go to a conference, ATA 21 and 36 conference. You know, who's interested in this? Well, just the pneumatic and air conditioning people, really. So suddenly you've got friends all over the place. I've got a friend in Cathay Pacific. I've got a friend in Lufthansa. I've got a friend in KLM. And when you've got a problem, you phone your friend in KLM. And suddenly your problems get fixed. And you become a very useful person in the organisation. It's so invaluable. So it's not about going and spending 2 days in Seattle. It's about the business card shuffle. That's what it's about. It's about making contacts. So, the daily goals. Ensuring that all processes and maintenance repair challenges are addressed in the most economic and operationally flexible manner. Ensuring the maintenance of the most stringent airworthiness standards without compromising quality. We don't want to compromise quality. It's cost cutting comes back and bites us very hard. And that message we've got to get across at the earliest possible opportunity. So doing thing, botching something, doing it in an incorrect way, you know, not only can it, you know, endanger the aeroplane, but not to exaggerate this. So we're not saying, talking about doing something so bad that we're going to lose an aeroplane. We're just inhibiting the aeroplane to perform in the best way, which will cost us money. Again, it costs us money. Monitor and update production schedules, performance charts, implement and obtain feedback for evaluation and future improvement. Again, we're looking at all these activities that add value to the process. And it's a ratio, and we've got to get the ratio right. So if I add a production planner in an environment where I've only got the hangar doing its own production planning, and I add a production planner, that production planner will, let's say, give you 100% return on investment, at least. What does it mean? It means that the production planner costs a salary, but he will save you two salaries. If I put another production planner, and we can start looking at some of this additional stuff that can really make a difference, then that additional production planner can give us four times his salary in savings. And I can add another production planner, and that will also give me four times his salary. And then I add another production planner, and it makes no difference. I'm losing salary. And it's being able to make that organisational calculation. What will it do? It will cut down on the AOGs. It will cut down on aircraft staying on the ground longer than they need to. It will cut down on tooling shortages. It will cut down on bottlenecks during the maintenance check, and so on and so on and so on and so on. So it's getting that balance right. And then I go to a company and I meet one guy, and he's looking after 20-odd A320s, production planning and maintenance planning. And I know that this company doesn't realise how much they're losing. And if they put, if first of all, separate with 20 aeroplanes, separate maintenance planning and production planning. And then you will immediately start to save. And then look at how you can add value.